Good evening, everybody. Thank you so much for being here. This is a very special night for me and for my family. I'm sure y'all know I'm Sherry, and music has been a passion of mine ever since I was very little. I sang my first solo in church when I was 5. I think you guys remember that. And I've been writing music pretty much since then. I wrote my first tune when I was 9, and I've always wanted to have something published and just get my music out there so other people could enjoy it and hopefully benefit from it. And a number of years ago, I did some work for Augsburg Fortress, which, for those of you who are in church world, it's the big publisher for the Evangelical Lutheran Church in America. So Ashley is one of the bigger publishing houses that publishes choral music, hymns, piano music, organ music. And a couple years ago, they came out with a new hymn book, and they wanted someone to write piano music for that. And so I did a couple for them. And so my editor really liked my work, and she says, you should do more. Well, life gets in the way, and I got really busy. But then about 2 years ago, when I decided to step away from serving in church, what I ended up doing was starting to write music again. And I wrote and I wrote and I submitted it, and believe it or not, it got accepted. And after 15 months, because it takes a long time, I'm proud to say that my first piano collection has now been released, and I'm delighted to share it with you tonight. And I've also got a very special guest who came all the way from Iowa, Richard Bruxvoort Collegian, who just also released a song of it. So he's going to be joining me later in the program. So if you are here tonight, it's not by accident. You're in my life, and that's not an accident either. And you've been part of this journey in some way, each and every one of you who is here tonight, from my workplace, from my yoga studio, from churches I've served, and my family. You've all been this journey and all part of this process, and part of you is in this work. So even though tonight is for me, it's a wonderful honor and a treat to be here to play this. It's also for you. But most of all, it is for God. So I'm going to open tonight with a very familiar tune to some of you, "A Vesper" or "A Mighty Fortress."
Thank you.
profusely thank the sisters for allowing me to become an omelet. Holy Wisdom. Yes, yes, you did. And the sisters, exercising their great Benedictine hospitality, smiled and said, yes, we're so very glad too. You know, they could have said something like, we like our eggs scrambled, or no, we like our eggs Benedict. No, they were wonderfully hospitable. So, what are omelets? We are men and women who are drawn to the rule of St. Benedict, an elegant rule that was written 1,500 years ago. And that is, we feel, just as valid today to help us sort out how to live more contemplatively in today's modern hectic world. And we're drawn to that because we want to be able to kind of draw inward in our spirituality to meet God. So there's a program here where you study the rule for a year and go on wonderful retreats and meet wonderful people. And at the end of that year, you rewrite the rule to fit kind of your life circumstances. And not surprisingly, I rewrote mine in music. Actually, Richard, one of your songs was in my rule. And so it's been a wonderful spiritual community for me and a wonderful grounding, stable force in the last several years. So I'm just thrilled to be here tonight and to share this with you. Omelets are not just, you know, contemplatives or artists, writers, pastors, therapists, mothers, fathers, conservationists. We are Catholic, Lutheran, Methodist, Episcopalian, Mennonite, Buddhist, Unitarian. So we're really a very diverse, wonderful group. So to honor you tonight, those of you who are part of my spiritual community, this next song is for you. It's called Beloved, God's Chosen, also known as Andrew's Song.
Thank you.
tired of the same old hymns being done in collections, and I just wanted to do something different. So back in the summer of 2013, I started looking over my files and realized I had a couple, and I thought, well, maybe I'll start writing some again. And my dad and stepmom were here in Madison, and actually, while we were waiting for you to come on over, I started looking over a couple of songs, and I started finishing them, and I finished two while you were here. So you actually started this, so you're to blame for all this.
Thank you.
So thank you, yes, thank you very, very, very much. So this next song is for you. This is called Kingsford, which is the hymn tune. It's known as Either Come Join the Dance of Trinity, or I Heard the Voice of Jesus.
Thank you.
vegetable gardener. And he was the total type A guy that was totally stressed out, so he was told to take up a hobby. So he took up gardening, but like a lot of type A people, he just translated all his type A traits into his garden. So for him, bigger was better. And it was a monster garden, wasn't it? And I remember asking my mom once when I was starting to garden, like, what did Grandpa do about his weeds? She's like, what weeds? I don't think a weed would dare to come across his garden. Most of what I remember from him was him trying to kick us out of the garden because we weren't really allowed in there because we might do something and trample something. And he was very successful at it. I mean, him, bigger was better. I mean, his zucchinis were ginormous, his tomatoes were ginormous. I mean, mortgage lifters, yeah, you could like take some people out with his vegetables. I don't know if they were any edible, but I mean, like I said, it was a very pristine, wonderful garden. So I had big shoes to fill. And I was at All Saints Lutheran Church for 4 years, about a couple of years ago, and they had a garden ministry, which was really wonderful. It was very nurturing. And they would just give away land plots that you could plant wherever you wanted, and they had people there that would help you. And so I learned a lot about gardening, although I still have a lot to learn, as Wayne will tell you. I still plant my tomatoes way too close, and I still plant my vines where they sprawl everywhere, where he goes after them with a machete. But he does. Then he sprays them with Roundup. That's what he did this year. We had issues with that. But anyway, I wrote this piece for the garden ministry at All Saints, and it's called Lord, Let My Heart Be Good Soil or Good Soil.
Thank you.
day. And I met him a couple of years ago, I think on Facebook, where you were looking for a piano arranger, although I knew your music because we had done it in my praise band and I used one of your songs for my role. And you were looking for someone to write piano arrangements for you. I'm like, well, yeah, I do that. So I answered and then you started sending me and we've been working back and forth just for the last 2 years and it's just been wonderful. I just love, you know, being able to work with other artists and musicians. So he's a psalmist. That's a hard word to say. He's a psalm scholar, and for those of you who may not be familiar, the Psalms is a book in the Old Testament, which is basically the songbook of the Bible. These are actually poems in a way, but they were songs intended to be sung, and they span the whole human emotional range from songs of happiness, joy, gratitude, to songs of anger, bitterness, anguish, everything in between. And it's my favorite book in the Bible. Many of you may know Psalm 23, the Lord is my shepherd. So Richard is writing songs to all 150 of them.
Wow.
And he just published his fourth album, Love Stands With, which are songs of longing and justice. And I told him, you will never find a more receptive audience than Benedictines here who are very much wedded to social justice. And so thank you. Your turn.
Led me to jump across to the other testament, that scene where Jesus is standing with the woman caught in the act, as the language says, standing right with that person.
Stands with the money.
Let's do another angry one, shall we?
I picked the sorry.
This one has a texture that we don't often sing in worship, and that is tapping into anger as being good fuel sometimes for change. When my wife Trish and I are angry with each other, we call that around our house change and energy. When one or both of us are angry, it means something's gonna change, one way or another. That's pretty exciting sometimes. You know what I'm talking about, I think. And as we think about what's needed in the world with the person next to us, with our children, grandparents, parents, our neighbor, or across the world, we can feel those things, those feelings that aren't always easy, and ask ourselves, what is mine to do?
Flow from you and return home.
Right back, so don't go anywhere outside.